Hello students, I hope you are doing fine. As you know, we have started a new chapter in biology, that is life processes. Today we are going to move on to the next topic, that is nutrition in plants and animals. Students, you have already studied what is nutrition and the types of mode of nutrition, autotrophic and heterotrophic. So plants make their own food by the process called photosynthesis. That is why the mode of nutrition seen in plant is autotrophic mode of nutrition. The raw materials used in the process of photosynthesis are carbon dioxide and water. Carbon dioxide is absorbed from the atmosphere through the leaves, which have tiny pores present on the surface called stomata. Water is another important element which is absorbed through roots of a plant by the process called osmosis. During the process of photosynthesis, oxygen gas is evolved as a byproduct which is released into the atmosphere. The food prepared by the green plant is in the form of simple sugar called glucose, which provides energy to plants for carrying out various processes. The equation is already given below. 6 carbon dioxide molecules react with 6 molecules of water in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll to produce 1 molecule of glucose and 6 molecules of oxygen. So oxygen is a byproduct over here and glucose is a food of green plants. So what are the important events that occur during the process of photosynthesis? There are 3 major events that take place during the process of photosynthesis. First is absorption of sunlight by chlorophyll. So chlorophyll is a green pigment which is present in green plants. Second, conversion of light energy to chemical energy and splitting of water molecules into hydrogen and oxygen by light energy. An equation is given below where water molecule in the presence of chlorophyll disintegrate into oxygen and hydrogen, and also energy is released during this process in the form of ATP. ATP stands for adenosine triphosphate. The third major event that occurs in process of photosynthesis is reduction of carbon dioxide to carbohydrates. So carbohydrate is a glucose which is the food for green plants. As you all know that carbon dioxide is absorbed through the stomata. Stomata are the tiny pores present in the leaves. So opening and closing of stomatal pores depend on guard cells. So there are 2 pictures given below of open stomata and closed stomata. A stomata consists of a pair of guard cells surrounding an opening called stomatal pore. You can see a stomata inside the guard cell. Guard cells are like kidney bean shaped and they are surrounded by epidermal cells. You can see in the picture, there is a nucleus present in guard cell which control all the activities in the cell. There is a vacuole which store food and water particles. And there is a chloroplast which contains a green pigment called chlorophyll. A stomata consists of a pair of guard cells surrounding an opening called stomatal pore. The opening and closing of the stomatal pore is controlled by the guard cells. When water flows into the guard cells, they get swelled, and which leads to the opening of stomatal pore. Similarly, when the guard cells lose water, they shrink and the stomatal pores get closed. When a plant does not need carbon dioxide, the stomatal pores are closed. So major function of stomata is to lead the exchange of carbon dioxide and oxygen. Oxygen is a byproduct and a gas. So oxygen is evolved through the stomata during the process of photosynthesis. And carbon dioxide is absorbed through the stomata. So that is the function of stomata. And how does stomata works? You should know by this picture and the process I have explained. So next topic that we are going to start is nutrition in animals. So animals, as you know, show heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Heterotrophic mode of nutrition means they depend on other animals or plants for their nutrition. Animals obtain their food from plants and other animals. Different steps in the process of nutrition in animals are as follows. The first process is ingestion, in which food is taken into the body via the act of eating or engulfing the food. Next process is digestion, the process of breaking down of large food particles into small particles which can be easily absorbed by the body is called digestion. What is absorption? Digested food products are absorbed into the blood stream and transported to cells. Next process is assimilation. The digested food which was already absorbed by the cells are then used for the production of energy needed by animals for various processes. The last process is ingestion, in which the undigested food or unwanted food is removed out from the body. That process is called ingestion. So there are 5 processes which take place during the intake of nutrition in animals. What are they? Ingestion, digestion, absorption, assimilation, and ingestion. Ingestion, taking food into body. Digestion, breaking down food. Absorption, moving food into cells. Assimilation, making food part of cell. And elimination, removing unused food. So students, we have already discussed how animals take up their nutrition. It is divided into 5 steps. First is ingestion, second is digestion, third is absorption, fourth is assimilation, and last one is ingestion. So in particularly, we will talk about amoeba now. So amoeba is a organism, unicellular organisms, and they take their food by the process of heterotrophic mode of nutrition, and in particular holozoic mode of nutrition. The process of intaking of food by amoeba is known as phagocytosis. So you can see in the picture, the first part, there is a food particle, and now the pseudopodia moves around the food particle. So this process is called ingestion. Amoeba takes its food through this process. Initially, it pushes out its pseudopodia, as you can see in the picture, so that it can encircle the food. So therefore, it can engulf the food. After this, it engulfs the food, thus forming a bag-like structure called food vacuole. In the second step, you can see a food vacuole is formed in the amoeba, and this process is called phagocytosis. Now, the next process is the third process of absorption. The process of absorption of the digested food material into the cytoplasm, leaving behind the undigested food material. That is the third process, in which food materials is absorbed and the undigested, the unwanted food material is left behind. Next process is assimilation. In assimilation, what happens? The food material which is absorbed is utilized for obtaining energy. That energy is used for the production or growth or repair, as well as for multiplication in amoeba. After that, the last process takes place. Finally, the cell membrane gets ruptured. You can see in the picture. And the fifth step, you can see that the cell membrane gets ruptured and the undigested food is thrown out of the body. So these are the 5 processes to show how amoeba takes up its nutrition. So that's all for today, students. I hope you are learning and practicing. Thank you. Stay safe.